Hi guys!
It's not everybody you can get married to.
Yes, so it's not everyone you can get married to. Just because you love someone doesn't mean the person is marriageable for you.
And just because you guys are in the same university or you wear the same clothes
yeah.
or you talk alike
yeah.
does not mean that yeah. the person is suitable for you.
True, actually, yeah. Because sometimes some people say, oh, you talk like this guy. You know, the girl like, I talk, both of you even look alike.
Yes.
You can actually look alike, but that doesn't mean you guys are suitable.
Yes. Yeah. You know the scripture told us in Genesis?
Yeah, Genesis chapter 2 verse 18. It says, now the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him a helper,
suitable,
adapted, complementary for him. So in other words, I could love someone, you could love somebody, but that doesn't mean the person is suitable for you.
Yes.
Yeah.
So the same way you go to a boutique to go get a shoe. For yeah. example, I got a shoe for my wife.
And I love it. I love this shoe.
Oops. But then it is not your size.
Aww.
Because it is not fitting for her.
Aww.
So the fact that you love something does not mean that it is suitable for you.
Yeah, that's the truth. It's true. Because you can actually love something, but if it's not your size, if you put your leg into it, you start having cracks on your leg.
Yeah.
That's what happens many of the times. People get into marriage loving somebody, but the person is not fit. The person actually does not have the same values. The person does not have the same mindset with him or her. The person's weaknesses are not weaknesses that you can actually marry.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it's not everyone's weakness that is marriageable.
True.
Yeah, because when you're saying I do to someone, you're not only saying I do to the person's strength, you're saying I do to the person's weakness. So you must know, who can I fit into? What kind of weakness can I fit into? Not every weakness you can actually fit into, you can adapt to.
That's true.
Yeah.
So therefore, as much as she likes the shoe,
yeah.
the shoe is not for her.
Yeah.
So sad.
I feel so bad.
But then, this is your size.
Yeah, that's true. Size 39.
I know you will like this. So when you go to a boutique and you buy this beautiful shoe, for example, guess what you see in the boutique? There's always a blue light that makes you not see the actual color
yeah,
of the
that's
shoe.
True. Yeah.
Take the shoe out of the boutique, out of the settings of the emotions, out of the settings of
your excitement. Yeah.
Just take a step and tell the seller, just give me a minute, I want to check the shoe out.
Yeah.
Take it out of the boutique and check if the color is really the one you want.
Yeah.
And if it's the one you want, you take it. But if it's not the one you want, you drop it.
Yeah, and that's why it's very expedient that you must investigate thoroughly before you invest your emotions.
True.
Yeah, and then when we talk about investigation, it's beyond physical observation.
Mm.
Because you can observe physically, but if you do not position your spiritual antenna very properly, you can still be deceived. Yeah, so that is why discernment is an automatic investigative tool that you must have to before you decide any relationship. Discernment is an automatic investigative tool that you must have before you decide any relationship.
True. The reason why a lot of marriages are failing is because many of us use the blue light eyes to review our shoe before we purchase it.
Yeah.
And if you decide to go return the shoe when you don't like it, the truth is that there's usually no refund.
Yeah.
And that is why in marriages, there's no refund after you purchase. The best you can do is to divorce and get somebody else. And it can be so painful and it's going to cost you so much.
Yeah.
So we advise that
you
investigate
before you invest your emotions.
Yeah. You must properly investigate before you invest your emotions.
Yeah.